risk management. There's one thing you should know for sure in a project. There are uncertainties that will hit you and torpedo your initial plans. The challenge is how to deal with the risks in your project. In risk management, your attitude toward risks played an important role. Are you a risk seeker yourself? Or do you feel more comfortable avoiding any risks upfront? What is your own attitude towards risks in a project? Do you see a lot of bears and pitfalls along the route? Is the famous glass of water half empty or half full? Your attitude will influence the outcome of a project risk workshop, and so does the attitude of your colleagues. Let's look at the proper formulation of a risk. In a project context, we distinguish the cause of a risk, the risk event itself, and its effect. The cause is the circumstance that exists today that provides uncertainty to your project. The event is the possible event that might or might not happen. The effect is the result of the event, which has an impact on the project objectives. Although most often the negative effects are considered, we stress the importance of the upside of risks as well. Opportunities are equally important. So there are two sides of the coin. The first side is the threats, and the second side is the opportunities. Let's illustrate the structured risk description. It helps you in selecting an appropriate mitigation strategy. Let's start with the cause. Cows are standing in a meadow, but there's no fence between the meadow and the water. As a result, a cow might fall into the water. Obviously, this will influence her milk production and hence the farmer's income. In the worst case scenario, the cow might even drown. What a loss of capital. Summarizing this in a structured definition provides, because of the absence of a fence in the meadow, the cow might fall into the water, which will decrease her milk production. Note that your attitude will influence the exact formulation of the risks and its effects. So, what to do about the risk? Typically, we can choose between several mitigation strategies. I mentioned four: terminate or avoid, treat or reduce, take or accept, and transfer. If we are really scared about the effects, we might want to avoid the risk. In our example, this means an empty meadow and the farmer changes business. Or second, we might decide to treat the risk by putting a fence in the meadow, hence reducing the probability of this event happening. This means we adjust the scope of your project in order to mitigate the risk. Or we just take the risk, but prepare a contingency plan in case the risk fires. So we could establish a hotline with a local crane driver. And as a fourth option, we might even want to transfer the risks to an insurance company. Where do the risk mitigation strategies fit into the risk management process? We start identifying risks, for example, in a risk workshop with the project team members. After gathering an initial list of the risks, they are assessed in terms of probability and impact. Based on this assessment, risks are prioritized and appropriate mitigation strategies are selected and further planned. The strategies are implemented. And finally, throughout the process, the outcome and status should be monitored and, if needed, action is taken. To prioritize risks, a so-called risk assessment matrix can be used. In a qualitative way, on the vertical axis, the impact of the risks is determined. On the horizontal axis, you see the likelihood of the risk. Here we use a 6-point scale for impact and a 5-point scale for likelihood. If the impact is high and the likelihood is high, This results, for example, in a maximum score of 30. As an organization, you need to think about what risks are you willing to take. This will probably be the greener areas. You can use a risk register to systematically store the identified risks and the proposed mitigation strategy. Here we give you the example of the cow. After category, you can even see that cause, event and effect or consequence are mentioned. Further on, the likelihood and effect or impact are presented. Also, the mitigation measure taken and who is responsible for the risks are listed in the risk register. Again, risk management is not a one-time exercise. It's a process that starts in the early project phases and needs throughout attention the whole process. Even more because the project might really benefit from upside risks, the opportunities. So that's the message we close with. Risk management does not stop after risk identification. It's a continuous process, safeguarding and improving your project.